if we look at those 164 countries, we find well over 1,200 climate change laws. That's a term we use very broadly. It's acts of parliament, but also executive orders and policies of a similar status. If you add all those things up, you have over 1,200 laws and similar policies around the world. That's a huge amount of legislation.
I want to congratulate the more than 160 nations covered in this study and the small but growing numbers who so soon after Paris are now drafting legislation in support of their NDCs.
It is important that we are clear about what parliaments are supposed to be doing in the climate change discourse. We are not saying that parliaments are there to negotiate international treaties. That's not their role, but they have to be at the table to be able to be aware of what is being discussed so that at the national level they can take action. And it is within their powers at national level to precisely devise the legislation that we're talking about today, but also to provide resources to the government and other partners to ensure that the provisions of the international agreement, in this case the Paris Agreement, can be implemented effectively at the national level.
We have the whole international community taking action on climate change. That's what I take out of the database. Obviously, the other thing that scientists tell us is all that exciting action hasn't been good enough yet. We have to strengthen it. We have to move, I guess, from the quantity of laws, the 1,200 laws that we have, to the quality of those laws to make sure that they're really tight, that are compatible with Paris, that they can be ratcheted up, and also that they're being implemented.